My fingers are falling apart. My glove is full blood.
I'm about to hit 10,000 golf balls over the next 30 days. The goal here is to find out how much that will reduce my current handicap of 25.6 by. That's 333 balls every single day for 4 weeks straight. Over $1,000 worth of golf balls. Let's hope this is worth it. This is shot number one. Ooh. And this is how we're gonna do it.
Step number one, establish my current handicap. I just played three courses in LA, Westchester, Woodley Lakes, and Encino. Then I plugged my scores into a handicap calculator, and we're currently sitting at a 25.6. Step number two, hit 10,000 golf balls. Ideally, they all go straight down the middle. Step number three, establish my new handicap. Play the same three courses again, and then sit down at the end to compare my scores and see how much my handicap has improved by.
My handicap has dropped by...
Pretty straightforward, right? Let's get going. I'm not gonna lie, the first couple days were pretty rough. There's a lot of shanking going on. It's kind of my body just getting used to hitting that many balls every single day. Around day four, day five, I felt more confident and the balls were going straight. And then around day eight, my body started showing the first kind of signs of wear and tear.
Hi guys, this is the situation right now. I'm hitting great shots, but my fingers are falling apart. My glove is full blood.
I taped up my fingers and got back on the range. Around day 10, the first signs of the real problem would start showing.
My back is fucked.
I tried to get back on the range the next day, but my back was too sore, so I came up with plan B. I was just gonna putt 300 balls every day until my back was better. As you can see here, my putting needed a lot of work. Got on the range the next day, but decided to just keep putting to rest up my back for my big lesson the next day.
I'm about to head over to the golf course and get my first lesson in about 4-ish years, I think. It's a weird thing to say, but hopefully he doesn't fix too much so that I don't have to change my entire swing fully.
Of course, that's exactly what happened. For anyone who actually cares, the main things he told me was to keep my club face closed during my backswing more, and then have more shaft lean on impact. I got back in range the next day to have the worst session I've had this entire challenge. Here's me being a little bit overdramatic.
Wrapped up hitting my two buckets. Out of the 230 balls, I would say at least 50% were shanks. So it's safe to say I don't think I've ever been this angry before playing golf. I was probably this close to throwing my 8-iron onto the driving range.
Of course we had to get back the next day, and yeah, we just kept going.
Quick update from day 17 here on the range. It's not going great. I just spent about half an hour watching YouTube tutorials sitting on the bench over there, which is never a great sign. Never a sign of confidence, really. Makes me question a lot of the stuff I'm doing, but we continue.
Day 18 and 19 onwards, I'd say I was getting more and more used to this new swing sequence. I still had to go back and putt a bunch because my back was really falling apart at some point. I went back every now and then to hit a couple balls, but the majority of the last 10 days were spent putting. And I was getting a little bit better. Look at this one.
It's kind of my first attempt to get back on the range after my back's been hurting. And it got super tight and sore towards the end again. So I didn't finish the whole bucket. And we'll try just, I guess, putt for the next 2 days and hope I don't lose my swing before I start playing the actual round to determine my score. Bit of a bummer this has happened. I guess it's good that it happened in the very end. Anyway, let's go putting. Something wrong with him. Got him all
bitter. I'm a bill printer. I'm a grave digger. The last three balls, 10,000 balls. My back is destroyed. I'm sick. It is raining. We're going to finish this right now and then see if my score has changed. Thank you for watching until now. Don't never stop. Hit all of them like that, we're good to go.
All right, here we are. This is what it has come down to. 30 days later, 10,000 balls later, About to tee off. I'm, for some reason, I should be really nervous, but I'm either not nervous because I'm somewhat confident or I'm just really tired. It'll probably get to me on the first tee, which should be any second now. Fingers crossed this was all worth it. Fingers crossed.
Okay, I will walk you through the first hole. My main thing here was that I didn't want to get double bogey or worse. First shot was off to the left, chipped it back onto the fairway, and got it onto the green in three, and then left myself a two putt that wasn't too bad. So finished off with the bogey on the first, which I was happy with. To be honest, most holes were like that. Oh, this is a bad one. I'm sure you guys have bad ones too. Went for every gap throughout the whole round. Did not find all of them. And luckily, all the putting practice I did ended up paying off. Make all of these really long putts, which saved a couple of pars and bogeys. Here's another one. Ended up shooting better than I did pre-10,000 shots, so I was happy with this one. On to round number two in Encino. My new miss is this little hook draw left, which I hit all the time into the trees over here. You'll also see I retired my driver because I hardly used it throughout the 10,000 shots. Similar again here, on the green with three shots, and then I left myself another two putt here. Again, this round two, bogeyed most holes. I did this a couple times where I fully thick it. I think that's because I hit so many shots on the mats at the range. A couple good recovery shots like this one, where I ended up with a par still. Overall, I didn't play as well as I wanted to on this round. Again, saved a couple putts. Played slightly worse than I did before because I played really well the first round here.
All right, last day, hole number one. Let's go.
Final round. Here we go. As you can see, not the best conditions. Decent first shot. Somehow, a little baby shank here to the right. This next shot is bad. Boom. I thought the water was going to slow down, which it obviously did not. And now I'm here, getting a solid double bogey on the easiest hole in the course. Look at this hole. Wow. Okay, we're jumping back to the last hole of the course here. Last hole of the challenge. First shot, straight down the middle. Beat myself about 100 yards or so. Chip it on the green on the right side there. And putt, two putt it. Yeah, two putt it. And finish off the entire challenge with a par.
Hey guys, I just wrapped up the third round. I'll get home now and then evaluate the results and we'll see what 10,000 shots actually did to my handicap.
All right, let me do a quick little update here. I just added all the numbers of my scores into a handicap calculator. And these are the results that we are looking at now. 10,000 shots later, about 60 hours spent on the driving range. Was it worth it? We're about to find out. My handicap has dropped by 4.4 strokes. It went from a 25.6 before to a 21.2 now. I dropped a couple of strokes on more courses. I gained two on one because I played really well there before. If you want to continue following along on this golf journey of mine slash of our channel in general, we will be posting golf videos every single week. There'll be challenges, there'll be match plays, there'll be interviews, there'll be anything we can think of really. I run some relationships with others. One of them is still better golf than me, but we'll see how long that lasts now that I'm pretty committed here.